As Christians, we believe that every human life is valuable, unique, and irreplaceable. This is one of the most important beliefs of our faith. If it wasn't true, it wouldn't have made any sense for Jesus Christ to come to earth and die for us. But he did. And because of that, we believe that the worth of a human being is not determined by the government, a vote of the people, a judge, or a person's parents. It's determined by God, who tells us in Jeremiah that before you were born, I knew you. The easiest thing in the world is to see the unique and irreplaceable value in someone who is smart, popular, rich, or powerful. But it is very difficult to see that value in someone who is weak, dependent, and vulnerable, like the elderly, the sick, and the dying. It is especially difficult to see it in someone who is unborn. These people do not seem irreplaceable because they do not seem to be doing anything important. They are not building bridges and skyscrapers. They are not going to college and starting businesses. They're not writing books, making lots of money, and getting interviewed on television. They're not getting elected to office or starring in movies or winning football games. In fact, in the eyes of the world, these unnoticeable people are not doing much of anything, other than making a carbon footprint and causing the rest of us a lot of work. Being Christian causes us to see things differently than the world sees them. The world believes that what makes life worth living is material wealth and accomplishments. But we believe that what really makes life worth living is love, generosity, and self-sacrifice. This belief should change the way we look at issues like abortion, euthanasia, and physician-assisted suicide. The world says that we need abortion because women can't find happiness if a baby comes between them and their plans. But Christ teaches that we need the unborn child because no one can find happiness without learning how to sacrifice ourselves for the needs of someone else. And who teaches this lesson better than a completely helpless and dependent unborn baby? The world says that we need abortion because women can't climb the ladder of success if an unexpected child comes along. But Christ teaches that we cannot be successful by sacrificing our brothers and sisters in order to get ahead. The world says that we need abortion because love means that every child should be a wanted child. But Christ teaches that if we kill people we don't want, we abandon the very heart of love. The world says that we need physician-assisted suicide because you lose quality of life when you are dying of a terminal illness. But Christ teaches that the best quality of life comes from accepting His love and mercy, something that is frequently easier to do when we are sick, frail, weak, and old. When we really understand that happiness, success, quality of life, and freedom are about giving ourselves for the good of others, it becomes easier to see why abortion and euthanasia undermine the very meaning of our lives. Our church is pro-life because the pro-life position reflects the very heart of Christ's ministry, a ministry filled with faith, hope, and love. As we were preparing for this talk, I thought about how Jesus Christ didn't have to come into the world in the form of an unborn child. He was God. He could have done anything he wanted. He could have entered as a mighty and powerful king, as an athletic champion, or as a great and terrible warrior. But he didn't. Why not? There's a reason why Christ chose to come into the world in the form of an unborn child. He was teaching us something. He was saying, "This is where love begins, and real power lies in love. If you can love the very littlest of all people, then you understand what being a Christian is all about."